Hello, nice to see you. And welcome to follow my vlog, Virkkuumania. Virkkuumania is Finnish and it means crochet mania. My name is Heidi and I live in Tampere, Finland. Last episode I was talking about my crocheted cardigans. And today I am talking about my finished objects and current whips, the projects that I am currently working on. I am filming in my summer oasis, perhaps the last time, because the autumn is already around the corner. And this is my second episode from the summer oasis, and I apologize beforehand about the background noise. There may be cars or children voices or dogs barking, but I just wanted to film it here tonight because the next time will be perhaps next summer. So and if you haven't heard about my summer oasis project, please visit my Instagram handle. It's Virkkuumaniassa. I will put it down here. And there is highlights in the stories about this summer oasis project that I have had this summer. But let's go on with the finished objects that I have managed to do after the cardigan, the granite cardigan. There is only two small projects. The first one, there was a granny square day, let me think, a week ago, 15th of August or 14th, 15th or 14th of August, and I made this beautiful square. The pattern is from a red, have to check, Crochet by Red Abage, I don't know how to pronounce it, I'm sorry, I will write it here, Red Abage, Abage, I don't even try anymore, but this is my granny square for the granny square day. The yarn is Drops Muscat and I have done it with 3.5 millimeter hook. I really love this heart motif in this square. And this was just one square that I made. Yeah. And my second finished object is a little bag. I made this during last weekend. I got a new phone from my work and it's huge, like really big one, and it's not easy to carry around in your hand. Because my work is that I have to move and walk and do stuff, so I can't keep it in my hand all the time. It's so big, so, and it's not very nice to put it in your back, to your pocket, back pocket in your trousers. So I made this little bag. Isn't this just a sweet little bag? I got the inspiration from Annabelia Craft Design blog. I saw this bag from her blog. There is two squares and I have joined them together, and I have also a linen here. So I have had to take my sewing machine, and I did some sewing, which is not my favorite thing, but I managed to do the lining for this bag. And I made, of course, a tassel one. I am very keen to tassels nowadays because of these my Ohoban things that I have over here. So I wanted to have a tassel to my bag also. And this time I didn't make any the straps are like from plastic, you know, straps. I didn't want to make a crochet one this time. And I just really like this bag. It's really nice. It's the size is 20 centimeters wide and then 20 centimeters long. I have also a blog post about this. I will link it to the show notes. And the yarn is Lion Brand's 24/7 cotton that I used for the Wild Rose backpack that I made in the beginning of the summer. And the backpack I have used it a lot, and the yarn has stayed very good, so I believe that this bag will endure my work life also. But yes, very quick weekend project, or in a one day. You can do this in a one day if you are fast with the lining thing. But yeah, I made the squares on Saturday and the lining on Sunday. And on Monday I had this with me at work. Yes. Those were my finished objects. Yeah. After the cardigan. Now I have been working corner to corner project a month now, and I will show it to you now, because did I show it before the cardigan episode? I don't remember anymore, but no, I didn't. Yeah, but I will show it to you now. This will be a pillow for my son. I got the inspiration for this C2C crochet from his t-shirt. And the other side, the first side is ready, and it says, oh my god, how do I show it to you? It says Kamer. Yes. And he chose the colors of this pillow. He likes orange and green, as you can see from this pillow. And I made a chart to a squared paper like this, and my husband helped me to draw the letters to here. And now I'm working on the other side of the pillow, and there will be a PlayStation. What do you call it? Joystick or game controller. And these both were on his t-shirt. There was Gamer. It was Gamer and the PlayStation controller in his t-shirt, and I was like, oh my god, I could crochet that one. Do you want a pillow that says Gamer? And of course he was very happy about my idea. I have made this Because I'm a lazy person sometimes, so I have made this so that these yarns are in the back side, like this, you can see it. And because this will be a pillow and you can see the other side of this piece. But when now I'm making the second part or the second panel, which will be the controller. This is the first corner, and I first started to make it that the yarns run through here, but then I realized that it's very long, long way to carry the yarn, because the design is like this, that you have the orange only in the outer sides and the green is in the middle. So I changed my technique and I took two balls of orange and I will change the ball every time I come to the orange section. I have one ball for this section and one ball for this section, and the green one is in the middle. And when I get to the point where I have to start to crochet these little black pieces over here, then I just take one black ball with this work. And I think I will be pretty tangled up with these yarns because they are already in like this. But I really like this technique. This is my second time that I'm doing C2C crochet. The first one was a pillow to the summer oasis. You can check that one from some episode, and I have blog post coming from that too, but it's not ready yet. But anyway, I really like this C2C technique. It's really fast and enjoyable crochet. But I hope to finish this in a month and to give my boy a new pillow, because he is such a gamer, PlayStation addict perhaps. And the yarn is my favorite, Drops Muscat yarn, and hook is 3.5 millimeters. Perhaps next time when I film, I have the finished pillow to show you. And I have another whip that I am not very excited about, and I don't know what to do with it. You may remember that in the spring, it was March or April, that I started to do a blouse in this color. I will put a picture here that you know what I'm talking about. And it didn't go very well, and I made mistakes, or the pattern was very, I think it wasn't very well written. But the project was lying in one of my drawers, and in the summer when I made an inventory to my yarns, and I found the blouse, and I was like, oh my god, but I was totally I totally forget all about it, and I was very sad because it was, I really wanted to have the blouse, but it just didn't work out nicely. And anyway, I needed to frock it and made it again, to make it again. But then I decided that no, I don't do it again, I just frock it, the whole project. And it took me 2 hours to frock the blouse. But I managed to do it, and I got, and now I have the yarn in little balls like this. And the yarn is DMC Natura Just Cotton bamboo, which is really nice yarn, and I really want to use it. And I have 500 grams of this yarn now that I want to use. And I searched and searched a pattern for a garment that I could make from this yarn. And then I found this Stitch Together. Yeah, Stitch Together official Instagram account. And they started this granny stripe poncho crochet along. And I started to do that. And I've been doing this 3 weeks. I started this 3 weeks ago, two weeks ago, and I have managed to do this much. But there's something that I don't know what is wrong with this. I really like the yarn. The stitch pattern is very easy, very mindless, easy thing to do, but there's something that is not quite, you know, I don't get this feeling that I want to crochet this, and I don't know what it is, but, and all the pictures about those granny stripe ponchos, they look so nice, and I want to have that to myself also. But there's something with this, I don't know if the yarn doesn't fit with the crochet hook that I am using. The pattern says to use 5 millimeter hook for the granny part and 4 millimeter to the double crochet part. And when I do the granny stitch part, it's not easy. It's the hook doesn't, and the yarn, they are not compatible, if you understand what I mean. And when I do the double crochets with the 4 millimeter hook, it feels much easier and easier. Sorry, I think that I have all the words are lost in my mind. I hope that you bear with me. But I will try to, you know, connect to this work, because I really would like to have this poncho for next summer. And I don't usually want to give up, because I already gave up for the first project that I was working on with this yarn, and I don't want to give up again. So I don't know. And I really like this color and this yarn. I don't know. Yeah. But let's see. Will this ever be a finished object? But now it's a whip, and I don't know. Yeah, but I'm working on this C2C and this one. And that's all about my projects, but I want to show you few things that I have purchased. First, enamel pins. I have first I ordered this cute magic. I think this is magic loop ring with single crochet stitches and a crochet hook from Pinpoints. I will put the name over here, Pinpoints, and it came all the way from Australia. I really like this. And the second pin that I ordered, this is from the USA, and this is so cute, little ball of yarn and a crochet hook. And this is from a menagerie of stitches. Yes. Oh, did I sew it all the wrong? Like this? Yeah. I really like this. I don't have many pins, but I could order those a lot nowadays. They are so cute. And then I have a project bag like this one. Isn't this just cute? This is from Sue Happy Creative from England. Yes. And there is this light violet linen. And there is all this cute. Can you see it? Yes. And I really like this one. The colors are so perfect. I saw this a couple of times in Sue and Happy Creative Instagram account stories. And I was like, oh, I really like that one. Oh, I really like that one. And the third time, I made the order. Sometimes you just have to order. And my granny square poncho whip is in here. Yeah, really like this. Yes. About what is coming. I don't know when I am filming again, because there will be 2 weekends full of program, and soon after that there's a Yarndale. So I don't know if I can film before Yarndale or will it be after Yarndale. It depends also how my whips are getting along, or is there anything to show or talk about. So I hope that I can film before Yarndale, or then it will be after Yarndale. Yes. But I hope you are all well and enjoy the last days of summer and have a nice autumn or winter or springtime, whatever you have in your side of the world. And I'm very happy and about the new subscribers that I have gained after last episode. Thank you very much for subscribing and pressing the thumb up. It really means a lot to me. Thank you very much and have a nice day. Bye bye.